When we are working with dimensional analysis and similarity, as well as doing the non-dimensionalization of the equations of motion, in our experimental work that we do, that is done to save time and money, and so that in a geometrical scale, on a smaller scale, we can replicate the real models on a smaller size. But it has to have relevance with the real fluid flow situation, even if it is being taken place in the laboratory. For example, if we have to model a new aircraft or a ship or a motor car with best of the parameters, normally we try to see that there is a minimum of drag, minimum of wastage of energy, minimum of heat being generated, and that kind of thing, and minimum of energy losses. And to improve the fuel efficiency of all these vehicles or other things that pertain to fluid flow situation, we need to consider what are the important things and parameters that we need to focus on while modeling small models in a laboratory and doing and carrying out our experiments. So important parameters, scaling parameters, have to be decided in a suitable, appropriate manner. The three primary purposes of dimensional analysis are to generate non-dimensional parameters that help in the design of experimental and in reporting of the experimental results. So just as I was saying, that if we are doing experiments, we are doing with the purpose of trying to produce something in real life. So if these experiments are not giving us the results that will help us to make a real flow, a real product, then those experiments are useless. So therefore, we need to do and design the experiments in a most suitable manner that help us in the design of real products. And the other object is to obtain scaling laws so that the prototype performance can be predicted from model performance. This is very important. And then to predict trends in the relationship between the parameters. The principal similarity of three necessary conditions for complete similarity between a model and a prototype. So what are these? One is they should be geometrically similar. So, geometrical shape should also match the real model as well as the one that is being developed or being worked with in the laboratory. The other is kinematic similarity. That is, when the movement is taking place, the motion is taking place, then the parameters and even these numbers that we mentioned, like Reynolds number or other relevant variables, they are similar to the real situation. And so therefore, if that is the case, then there will be a level of proportionality between the two situations. The other important thing is the dynamic similarity. When all forces in the model flow scale by a constant factor to corresponding forces in the prototype flow force the equivalence. So again, in all these things, whether the geometrical similarity or the dynamic similarity or the kinematic similarity, we have to see that things match with each other, that things have relevance to the real flow situation as well as in the laboratory. This is not easy to model an experiment that will give you the same result when you produce the product in real life is not a simple thing. Designing experiment is difficult, but if one can make it successfully by making use of different techniques, methods that we have just mentioned, and some of the things, and keeping the parameters proportional to each other, matching with each other, then good results are produced. And we see every day that even the three examples that I just mentioned, for the sake of mentioning, although there is a large number, there is a long list, but for example, these three, like aeroplane or a ship or a car, after all, every other day, new cars, new aeroplanes, and new ships are designed, they are made, they are produced, and used in real life. How they are done? Again, experiments, lot of research work is done on their designing, on their production, before the final product. And the experiments are carried out very carefully so that the maximum benefits could be obtained. And if that when that thing is achieved, we have excellent, precise products that are useful to the humanity and for other purposes.